All right, just quick update. Let's get started. Picked up a cheap soldering kit for $24 on eBay. Worked good so far. I took apart my 350Z radio because the radio I have right now in my car is meant for my iPhone, and I don't have an iPhone anymore. I switched to an Android phone, yada yada yada. But I can't plug in my phone because the connectors are not the same anymore. So I'm just going to put an auxiliary headphone jack in. Reading up on the forums, I'm only supposed to use the left audio channel, right channel, and ground it off in between three wires only, right there. It's a pain in the ass to take this thing apart because sometimes the screws don't want to come out, but it's kind of crazy that the deck actually was just like a plug and play, just snaps all together. I thought it'd be like a lot more simpler, very simpler radio, but it has a lot of shit going on there. But this is the cassette deck though, and I do have CDs, so I don't want to mess up the CD player because I don't know what the hell I'm doing there. But in the forums it does say you can solder on to the back of these points, and it should be able to give you a good quality. The best quality a headphone jack can get you, nothing crazy. So, but just a quick mod, and there's a kit online from Grom Audio. I mean, it's a good kit. It's $150, but I don't have $150 to shell out right now. But I would get it, and then you'll be able to, actually change the, actually go into your settings and change everything through here. You won't even have to actually touch your phone. But, this is just a quick fix. And the only thing I'm going to probably spoil is the cassette deck. If it spoils, I'm not sure how I'm going to end up. Alright, later guys. Okay, so what I did was take a normal, I guess you would call them an A&N cable. See, I'm using my phone to do this. It's pretty good. So I just chopped the end of it. I'm not going to use this part, but I'm using this maybe like about a good 5 foot cable. So then I can slip it through the deck, and of course it has that's two male ends to it, right? So then this will go right into the phone itself. So what I did was just strip back the ground, which is gonna go. Okay, I know there's a lot of light. Let's see if I can fix that. Can't fix that, sorry. Gotta get used to this phone. Whatever. There we go. So, of course, ground to A ground, and I'm just gonna go to right, left, and left channel. Honestly, I don't know which is gonna be which is gonna be right and what's gonna be left. I should find that out first, and I'll come back to you. Okay. And you don't know, you pick up some of your old shit, and, well, not old shit, some of your other stuff, and find out. There we go. Ugh, come on, this assisted light is too damn bright. There we go. So, white is left, red is, right. Let's make it easy on ourselves. Okay, this ground is being a bitch of a biatch. Oh, look at that zoom. Ow, 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 ow. Ow. Piece of shit. Ow. That was really hot. Okay, so I did a city soldering job, okay? That's really bad looking. If you want to put a close-up of it. And it's a horrible close-up. But the ground wire, for some reason, not getting proper soldered, everything else is on there pretty tight. I hope. Let me wiggle it right here. It breaks in front of you guys. You can laugh at me. shrink that down. So whatever, at least my, you know, I don't want no hissing noise or any kind of distortion. That's mostly gonna come from the ground wire. And I'll put this thing together, and tomorrow I'll put it in the car. It's like 1 a.m. right now. I'm gonna play some video games. The rig is not finished yet, but I'm working on it just in case. But it's there, and monitors are kind of heavy and it's bowing down that table, but I'll finish it up. I mean, it's simple. I just gotta finish up my chair and I should be fine. It's just a mess and I just got lazy, but I'll finish everything up. Okay, the other thing the forum says to do is to, there it goes. There's this little mechanism when you push a cassette in, I guess, you know, it activates, letting it know that the cassette's in there. What some people do from, you know, again, reading this, they took out the spring. Some people actually took out the whole mechanism from what I saw, you know, in the forums. What I'm going to do is, okay, so, put a little bit of tape there. The forum says to remove these two little pieces, the sliding mechanism, the spring that's usually right here. And I put a little bit of grease on the cogs. And I'll reassemble, put it in the car, test it out. I mean, hopefully the soldering works. If not, I didn't lose anything. Just wasted time, not money. And let's see if it works. Hopefully it works. Then save myself some time of doing anything, and I can put back my stock deck. I do believe this, you know, it looks better than what I have in there right now. I mean, I put in an Alpine, but I'll show it tomorrow. And yeah, something about the original deck and the color scheme of the car will go good with it. Alright guys, see you guys soon.
Okay, hope this works. I'm supposed to press the eject button before anything happens. Key on, says tape. And there it goes. And that's it. So it's working. So it works. I should try that, right? And also the volume here works on it. A little bit of static going on. I think I use a flimsy ass cord. Man, that's my old shit right there. You can probably see it. But yeah, that's about it. Sorry, the car's a freaking mess. I haven't cleaned up in a minute. So it's winter and it's raining outside right now, of course. Yeah, let's see. Something's up there. product. There it goes, it works. I gotta run. Oh, I hope this helps. It was a pain in the ass at some parts, but you won't spend nothing, that's how you do it. It takes a little bit of hard work, or annoying work. Alright, later guys.